Yesterday, we added robotics and maker curriculum into the Code Club app, and we are so excited. Today, I wanted to dive a little bit deeper into what this curriculum holds and what kind of experiences your kids are going to be having in Code Club when you utilize the curriculum. So let's click in here, first of all, to workouts. And again, you'll see our normal tracks, but then you'll see four new tracks: Makey Makey, Ozobot, Raspberry Pi, and Sphero. Makey Makey is this, they call it an invention kit for the 21st century, and it's basically this little electrical engineering board that allows you to hook up your computer to anything that conducts electricity in the real world and create. You can code in Scratch or in any platform you want to, and it basically becomes this connection point from your computer to the real world. So we, in our app, we introduce the kids to how to set it up for the first time, use it in some really simple ways, and then in workout two, we get a little more complex, and then a little more complex even yet in workout three. And then we have some really cool projects utilizing the Makey Makey in the missions side of things. We have this one called the Hero Museum Day, where the kids are going to have to create an interactive display that tells the story of their life. They're going to have to use the Makey Makey and somehow rig it up to do what we're asking it to do here in the project. Additionally, we have the Talking Book project. This is a Makey Makey mission where they're going to have to wire up a book that when they do certain things in the book, it's going to connect to the code and it's going to do different things on the computer and so on. So this is going to be a really cool project as well for your kids. Next, we have the Ozobot, and the Ozobot is a little robot. If you haven't heard of these things before, they're really cool. They're just like an inch or inch and a half big mini programmable robot, and you can program them to do a lot of different things. They've got sensors in them, so they're sensing light. They can do all kinds of cool things. So in our platform, we introduce the kids to what the Ozobot is, how to get it set up for the first time, some basic functionality with Ozobot. Then we start having them do some kind of hour of code Ozobot type stuff. And if they don't know how to code, they'll learn some of the basics of coding right here in these first two activities. So if you have new kids who are coming and they're starting on Ozobot, it's a great place to start. And then we, you know, just have some fun stuff for the kids to do there in the Ozobot curriculum. It gets harder and harder, so that by the end of this track, they're doing pretty complex stuff, building some pretty cool things. Then on the mission side, we've got a couple Ozobot projects as well. I'm just going to show one of them to you for now, but this is a collaborative mission. We're going to have kids work together in pairs or more to accomplish this mission, but basically they are going to rig up their Ozobot to clean up the beach, just like you see in this video here. So they're going to tape stuff to their Ozobot. They're going to program it to go across this piece of paper and clean up the beach. So it's a pretty cool project. The kids are going to have a lot of fun with that. And it's going to be really good. Third, we have the Raspberry Pi. If you're not familiar with the Raspberry Pi, it is a computer that fits in the palm of your hand. It's a very simple computer, and Raspberry Pis are famous in kind of the hacker maker community because they're very customizable. You can get a Raspberry Pi to do pretty much anything you want it to do. So we're pairing these with a inexpensive inventor kit that comes with all kinds of sensors and a breadboard and stuff like that. So if you're going to use our curriculum for Raspberry Pi, you're going to need both the Raspberry Pi and this inventor kit. But again, in the Raspberry Pi, we introduce them to what it is, how to kind of get it set up for the first time. We're going to have them take a selfie and use buttons, and there's lots of interactive stuff in this curriculum as well. We're going to introduce them to Minecraft in the Raspberry Pi. So if you've ever wanted to code with Minecraft, this is your chance. Minecraft is built into the Raspberry Pi operating system, so we're going to get the kids coding and modding Minecraft right here in our platform, which is huge. Kids love doing this. This is one of the best ways to learn how to code. And then over on the mission side, we've got some really cool missions for the Raspberry Pi. Kids are going to make a legitimate photo booth where they push a button and it takes their picture, you know, takes like three pictures with a pause in between, a couple second pause in between each picture. So that's going to be really awesome. And then there's another mission in here as well. Lastly, we have the Sphero. And Sphero is probably the most exciting device that we have because they're just awesome. The Sphero has done an amazing job creating a really cool product, but they're these robotic balls that are a bit bigger than the Ozobots. These basically will fill your whole hand, and they move in really cool way, and they've got sensors and lights and sounds, and you can do some really cool stuff with them. So again, in our curriculum, we introduce them to what a Sphero is, how to use the app and the coding platform that comes with Sphero, creating an account, just basic stuff like that. And then we introduce increasingly more complex ideas with the Sphero as they go. And then we've got some really cool missions specifically for the Sphero, such as the Oregonian Trail. You know, just a cool project that the kids can connect with, and it's going to be a lot of fun. So there you have it. That's some of our content. We're going to be adding to both sides, both the workouts and the missions, pretty regularly. With all four of these, there's really no end to the amount of missions and the types of missions that you can do. So we're going to really be hitting the project side hard in the future on these four devices. If you don't own these devices, check out our buying guide. We link right to both Amazon and the manufacturer's websites where you can buy all of this stuff. Said, enjoy the new curriculum. Let us know how we can help and improve it. And let's build something awesome. Thanks.